This research project entitled Authentic Interactive Activities to Promote Oral Production on a Virtual Platform. The necessity of learning English as a foreign language is increasing in the Mexican educational field, especially in the academic one. In that attempt, students are supposed to learn how to write, listen, read, and speak it, to use the language as a way to convey messages. However, the last skill represents an obstacle for the majority of learners who struggle with different problems as pronouns, isolated vocabulary, phrases, or disconnected sentences. That is why the present research is important, because it could offer some alternatives to avoid those obstacles. At this point, there are many studies in the state of the art that propose different means to improve oral production, which include learning and communication strategies, techniques, approaches, methods, or activities that promote that production in on-site spaces. Nonetheless, what could teachers do when the development of such a skill has to be outside the classroom, in a non-native context, and under virtual learning due to current circumstances? Taking into account the situation described above, the objective of this study is to know if an instructional design with interactive activities operated in the Moodle platform promotes oral production, and identify the possible association between subjects' scores from that instructional design and their speaking level from a standardized test. For the present research, a longitudinal quantitative approach was carried out during spring 2020 in the Teaching English Bachelor at the Benemérita Universidad Autónoma de Puebla. The selection of this methodology was due to its advantages regarding measuring subjects' speaking level with checklists and rubrics during the instructional design to analyze quantitative data and changes during 4 months. Then, those results were compared with the speaking scores gotten from a standardized test to identify possible relationships between variables. Regarding the sample, it was randomly selected and composed of 20 subjects who share common characteristics like have synchronous sessions 4 hours a week and work independently on the platform at least 10 hours a week. All of them accredited V1 and V1 Plus in speaking. The data gathered from the subjects' scores of the instructional design was analyzed according to this model of analysis. The following graphic presents the subject's scores from the instructional design. As shown in the graphic, the scores demonstrate that authentic interactive activities promoted subjects' oral production to reach a different level of command, mainly based on 2 reasons. Competencies and descriptors of V2 included in the design, and the actual proficiency level at the beginning of the course, that was B1 and B1 Plus. During this course, they show a quite broad language level to accomplish clear and accurate descriptions with a standard rhythm, complex grammatical structures without mistakes that causing misunderstanding or finishing the conversation. They also monitor their participation and did corrections by themselves when necessary. In general, they carried out the following. 1. Give detailed explanations and reasoned arguments to defend their position towards a topic. 2. Analyze a topic according to the advantages and disadvantages it could provide. 3. Speculate possible causes or relationships of a given topic. 4. Have successful participation in formal and informal speeches by explaining, showing pros and cons, evaluating possible solutions, confirming or refuting hypothetical situations. 5. Emit respectful comments by supporting their speech with their experience, facts, or authors. 6. Use linguistic competencies and conversational strategies to keep on in a conversation. In summary, subjects from this study should be on a B2 level or more, because they could manage themselves suitably in the course as mentioned before. However, the previous conclusion needs some corroboration. For that reason, subjects' scores were associated with their speaking scores from a standardized exam to answer the second research question of the present study. Based on the findings, there is an association between the scores from the instructional course and subjects' proficiency level. Indeed, it is evident. The students who got a higher grade in their virtual classes did the same in the proficiency exam. Thus, this study confirms both research questions and concludes that the proposal consisting of using authentic interactive activities to foster oral production guides to reach a higher level. Conclusions. First of all, the findings show a clear improvement of subjects' speaking proficiency level and thus linguistic knowledge. It also provides information for teachers to improve their pedagogical practice in virtual environments, to work with oral production, or even to adopt this methodology and proposal to foster other skills or sub-skills. Besides, authentic interactive activities provide an alternative to develop oral production, which are a high possibility of teaching in these times when education has migrated to virtual modalities. By using those said activities, subjects improve their speaking proficiency level, showing acceptable parameters of interaction and performance, not only in the instructional course, but also in a standardized exam. Furthermore, subjects develop a sense of virtual community where the average participation was high and characterized by their motivation to speak more naturally and spontaneously, as well as learn from others not only content, but also culture and social rules to interact without that typical fear and lack of motivation that is common in traditional classrooms. The demands and requirements from the authentic interactive activities push learners to be engaged in speeches with enough information to discuss and keep the rhythm in clear, accurate, and meaningful turn takings. Another key feature is that subjects didn't demonstrate being under pressure or stress to perform oral productions. Finally, it is worth mentioning that one possibility to enrich this research is by analyzing it qualitatively, to have a broader scope on perceptions towards the instructional course, and in that way, taking some decisions regarding its design, redesign, implementation, and evaluation. References.